The new iDVR-PRO surveillance DVRs are 960H CCTV format and use the latest H.264 video compression. These DVRs can record video surveillance using the following recording modes: continuous, scheduled, motion detection, alarm, panic, and intensive mode. Watch this video and I'll show you how easy it is to set up any of these video recording modes on an iDVR-PRO. Here's a live camera view on an iDVR-PRO. I'm going to access the main menu down here and select Record Setup. On the main Record Setup screen, you can change the mode from auto configuration to manual configuration, and we'll get back to that in a minute, what that does. And down here, you can select your continuous recording. I'm going to change it right now to motion. And in here, you can set each camera's resolution, frame rate and frames per second, quality, and whether the audio, if there is an audio mic associated with that camera, is on or off for recording. And then down here, you can set up the pre-recording time and the post-recording time for when the motion event occurs. I'm just going to cancel out there so I can show you some of the other modes. The alarm recording mode looks almost identical to the recording mode. Actually, it is identical. Same thing, you can set each camera's frame rate and everything. And then there's a motion and alarm recording, so that recording is triggered when motion is detected by a camera or from an external alarm sensor. And then what these intensive modes are the intensive motion is, let's say you want to record at a lower frame rate and resolution continuously when nothing is going on, but then while the camera detects motion, you want to bump the resolution up to the max and the frame rate and the quality. That's what these intensive modes are for, which are really handy if you want to record continuously but not use up all your disk drive space, so you make the resolution lower, and then when the motion is triggered, then it goes to a higher resolution and frame rate setting. So the intensive alarm recording is the same thing. You just set up the different frame rates and resolutions for continuous versus alarm recording, and then intensive motion and alarm is again the same thing, but you set up the frame rate for if there's motion detected or an external alarm triggered to record at the higher frame rate. If I change this mode from auto to manual, the menu changes a little bit. So now if I select continuous recording, I can actually set up schedules, and I can set up different resolution and frame rates and quality based on the hours of the day. So if I want different resolutions and frame rates at certain times of the day, that's what these settings are for. And you can make it per camera for every hour block in a day different if you'd like. But the more important thing, or more commonly thing used, is the schedule. So in here, for each camera, I can set up how many, which hours in the day that this particular camera is going to record continuously. So every camera can be different. So I'm just setting some different cameras as an example, setting this one to record all 24 hours in a day, and those first two cameras recording, different, 6 or 7 hour blocks, whatever I selected up there. So I'm going to close out of that. Actually, I didn't want to go out of the recording screen, so let me go back into the recording screen. So again, I'll go into Record Setup. So the next thing I want to show is panic recording. What panic recording is there's a panic button on the front of the DVR that you could just press to override and initiate recording, and you can set the frame rates for each camera for panic recording. Again, there's a button on the front of the DVR to trigger this, and then you can also trigger it via this menu if you hover the mouse down here. This is the panic record button that you can click via the mouse, and then that P in each of those windows is indicating that panic recording is triggered, and now I just went back to the continuous recording that's set up.
I really love how easy the new iDVR-PROs are to use. I do not think I've tested an easier-to-use interface on a standalone DVR in all of my years doing research and development at CCTV Camera Pros. If you would like to learn more about iDVR-PRO CCTV DVRs or you would like to request a demo so you can log in to an iDVR-PRO from an iOS device, Android device, Mac, or Windows PC, please visit www.idvrpro.com. Thank you for watching.